In this video, you will learn how to measure your GNOME extension performance. You can use the code I wrote to monitor the performance of your code. Download performance.js file from my GitLab repository and create a copy of it inside your extension folder. We will use this file to measure our code performance. I want to import performance file to my extension. Get current extension as me. Now you can import the performance file like this. Inside performance file, we have two main functions, start and end. You can measure the performance between start and end. I'm using test1 as a unique ID for my test. I create a loop between start and end that can consume some RAM and CPU. You can read the performance result in log. As you can see, our code took 15 milliseconds to run and used 4.1 megabytes of RAM. You can also use performance as nested block, but since each start and end can consume some CPU, I recommend to use it once at a time. This block will be logged first. This block will be logged next. This block will be logged at the end. Log happens on each performance that end. As you can see, we have the result of each block with unique block ID. Test 3 block didn't consume any RAM, but test 2 block that we have loop in it consumed some RAM. Just because reading the performance code can help you to learn more, I explain the source code for you. I released the code under MIT license. To run this script, you need libgtop2. You can install it like this if you don't have the package on your system. I'm using glib here to get the current time. And with gtop, I can get the memory usage. And timing, ID and start time will be stored. IDs holds the block ID name, so we know which ID should be used when you call end. And here we get the memory reference, so we can have access to the current memory usage. And here, we hold the used memory when you call start. In a start function, we check whether the ID has been started before. First, we get the current time in microsecond. Then, we add the ID to the IDs. And also, we add the current used memory in bytes to mem usage on a start variable. Current used memory function is here. We get the used memory with glaptop. In end function, we check whether the start has been called before. We get the last ID from IDs and also remove it from IDs. And here we calculate the difference between now and the time you use the start. And here we calculate the difference between current used memory and the used memory when you call the start. We don't need that ID in timing anymore. You can get the info from metadata.json like this. Friendly bytes function converts bytes to more readable units. For measuring GNOME shell performance, you can use Sysprof. You just need to mark the shell process here and click on the record button. You need root permission to start. And when you stop, the information about GJS, GObject, GLab, and everything else about GNOME shell will be here. You can also select a range to view the information related to that range.